Hey you guys, and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new, thank you so much for stopping by. Today I'm here with another pregnancy update for weeks 27 and 28, which is awesome because it means I'm in my third trimester and I'm definitely feeling it. So if you guys are interested to see how things have been the past couple weeks, go ahead and keep watching. So like I said, I am 28 weeks now and officially in the third trimester, and I'm just so excited about that because at this point, baby's development is pretty much there. All of the main key important things have grown and developed, and now we're just focusing on baking and plumping that baby up. So that is really super exciting. It's just crazy to just be at this point in pregnancy. It's just amazing. I'm super grateful for it. But with the third trimester comes a whole new batch of symptoms. I'm definitely feeling big, definitely getting tired again. So, you know, like I was really tired in the first trimester, as most women are, and then now I'm starting to feel that tiredness again, so I'm taking every opportunity to nap and sleep in that I possibly can. So as far as weight gain goes, like I've said in most of my updates, I don't really weigh myself anymore. I'm not worried about it. I just weigh myself, you know, when I go to the doctor each month, which I think my appointments change every 2 weeks, maybe. After this next appointment, I don't know. Yeah, so I just let them weigh me and let them tell me, you know, how things are looking that way. So at this point, I really have no idea how much I weigh, but I know I've gained at least 20 pounds at this point. I wouldn't be surprised if I'm over 25 by now. So I am definitely wearing maternity clothes, mostly maternity clothes. This is the dress I got from Old Navy. It's a newer one I ordered online like 2 weeks ago, and I got a couple other things from them, just like clearance items. It's so hard to buy maternity clothes when you know you're not going to be wearing them for very long, but you know, hopefully I could have another pregnancy and maybe wear some of these things again. But like, this was probably less than $15. Actually I think it was $17, but anyway, so I try to buy pretty inexpensive maternity clothes just because you're not going to get a ton of use out of them, but it is nice to wear maternity specific clothing because it is just more comfortable. And so yeah, I just got a couple things that I can wear now as my belly starts to really get big and like transition through to spring, because we are due May 4th, and so it will start to warm up here in Utah, you know, in April. It'll start to warm up a little bit. So yeah, I'm going to want to have a few things that I can wear that will fit me and hopefully get me through until I actually have this baby. Okay, so I still don't have any stretch marks on my belly or hips or butt or anything, but like I've mentioned in all my pregnancy updates, I have stretch marks on my chest because I grew rapidly I think I was about 8 or 9 weeks and it was very noticeable that my chest was growing. So that, I definitely have stretch marks on my chest, but no stretch marks anywhere else yet. I am actually sleeping still really well. As long as I use my, like a pillow between my legs and like a little wedge pillow behind my back, I'm sleeping pretty well. I always wake up on my back, but I can't really control that. I've tried to make it so I, you know, put pillows around where my back so that I won't end up on my back, but I do, and some mornings I wake up just like really achy because I end up waking up on my back, but for the most part, I'm sleeping pretty well, and I haven't felt the need to get a pregnancy pillow because I don't think I would like them, because even the pillow that's in between my legs is pretty flat, and most pregnancy pillows are pretty bulky, and I don't know if, like, I tried using a bulkier pillow in between my legs this week, and could not handle it, so I had to go back to like, it's like this thin, like a really thin pillow between my legs because I just need the smallest little lift there. But yeah, as long as I can get comfortable, which usually it's not too hard, I'm out and I'm sleeping really well. I'm probably waking up just once to go to the bathroom right now in the middle of the night, and I'm definitely snoring, so I feel bad. Every morning I'm like, did I snore? I ask my husband Eric if I snored, and he's like, yes. And sometimes he records me, gets a video recording of me snoring. But hopefully, I told him the other day, I'm like, hopefully this is just a pregnancy thing and I'm not like cursed to be snoring now for the rest of my life. Because that would be annoying, mostly for him. I'm sleeping great, but I hope, you know, it's not too rough for him. Okay, so for the best moment of the past couple weeks, I'm gonna say it was yesterday going swimming and just having a good amount of time of being weightless in a pool has seriously been, it was so amazing. It was like an immediate like lift from gravity and release. And that was so awesome. So if you're pregnant and you haven't been swimming yet, I highly encourage you to go and swim, like get that, get, and it was nice to like move around in the water. It just felt really good. So when I think of the best moment of the past couple weeks, that's the first thing that jumps into my head. But there are, I'm sure there were a lot of good moments in the past couple weeks since I last updated you guys. Another great moment was passing my glucose test. I was very happy to have passed that. That my number was supposed to be under 140 and I was 137. So I feel like I kind of barely passed it, but I passed it. So, and my doctor was not worried or anything. So yeah, I'm glad that I don't have to deal with that. As far as anything I'm missing, I'm just missing, and I may have mentioned this in other updates, I'm just missing being able to maneuver around easily, get my shoes on easily, work out with no problem, and just really push myself in workouts. But I just keep reminding myself this is just such a temporary thing, and most important thing I can do right now is just take care of my body and rest and just love on my baby and this big growing belly, because this isn't gonna last forever and I really wanna cherish these moments. But I do sometimes miss just being able to like get up and go and not have to like wobble around to get places. Okay, as far as movement goes, I am feeling so much movement the past week. In fact, oh my goodness, the other night I was laying down on my left side and I felt her just like going at it, just punching and kicking and whatever, doing cartwheels, backflips, whatever she was doing in there. And I felt this really strong kick on my left side because I was laying down on my left side and I felt it was really strong. And it was like she like kicked and held it there and I could feel sort of like a little tiny outline of her foot. Like I just knew it was her foot. It was the craziest thing. It was like one of the first times I felt like, oh my gosh, there is a real live human inside me with limbs and bones and feet. And I was just like, oh my gosh, this is so cool. It's not just some weird like alien in there. It's like a real live person. And it was just like a cool moment to connect with her. It's just crazy. So cool. I think that's one thing I'm just really gonna miss when I'm not pregnant. And so I'm really just every day taking time to lay down and just like feel her go crazy and wild and just kick around. I love it. So this week I have actually had an interesting craving. I mean, it's interesting for this pregnancy because it's the first time in this pregnancy that I have craved salad. Like, I want basically any kind of salad. I just keep thinking about salad a lot. I have ordered salads at restaurants a couple times this week. I got the Chick-fil-A just Cobb salad because Eric has the app and they give him like a free entree every month, and just so happened to be a Cobb salad this month, so he gave it to me and I was like, it was so good. And then I went to another restaurant yesterday and ate a salad. So good. I've made a salad at home and I think I want to go maybe get some stuff and make more salads this week because I love that I'm craving salad, like lettuce, and just it doesn't even matter like what kind of dressing's on it. I am totally digging salad, so I'm definitely gonna take advantage of that. I've been craving like carrot sticks and yeah, just healthier, crunchy veggies like cucumbers and tomatoes. Yeah, so that's an awesome craving, but I'm not gonna lie. Have had a couple moments the past couple weeks where I've very much craved ice cream, which that's also kind of a new thing because the past few years I have not really liked ice cream that much, and in just the past 2 weeks I've gone to Dairy Queen twice and gotten like their tiny little, they have these little mini blizzards, they're this big, and it's just like the perfect little fix. So between ice cream and salad, I think I'm balancing things out okay. So at this point, nothing is making me really like queasy or sick. However, I do have to make sure that I'm eating consistently because I will get a little bit nauseous. But nothing like how it was in the first trimester. I just don't feel great and I get hangry for sure if I let myself go a little too long before eating something. When I wake up in the morning, I eat right away because otherwise I don't feel great, and I just feel like I start the day off better if I just eat as soon as I wake up, basically. And then, as far as symptoms go, I've been a lot moodier lately, a lot more emotional, kind of clingy. And then, I've also been really achy. My tailbone has really been bothering me. Like, as far as, like, if I sit too long, it starts to ache. If I walk too long, it starts to ache. So even like going for walks that are longer than like just to the park have been kind of hard for me. So that's a little frustrating because I do enjoy taking my dog Poe on a walk, but I've had to just kind of gauge day by day how I'm feeling and, you know, walk. But if it starts to hurt, like my tailbone starts to hurt or my back starts to ache too much, then I just go ahead and turn around and come back home because it's just not worth feeling achy and sore after that, because it's not just during the walk. If I feel achy during a walk or throughout the day and I don't give myself time to rest, then it'll hurt even worse even when I'm done walking. So I've been trying to figure out the balance between staying active and getting enough rest, and it's kind of tricky. So at this point, my belly button is still in. I totally thought it would have popped out by now, but it's still an innie. It's definitely stretched, but it is still an innie. My wedding rings are off. I have no rings on my hands right now, my fingers. And all of them are off by, well, I really only wore my little wedding band. It was off by 25 weeks. The next question is, are you happy or moody most of the time? I'd say like, it's like 40, 60. I'm like moody 40% of the time and, or like emotional. And then like 60% of the time I'm happy. Most of the time, I'm happy and grateful and just like seriously on cloud nine. But then I am just like also just so moody and whiny. And yeah, I feel bad for Eric. But I'm trying to be better. I'm trying to be like, you know, balance it out. And to be honest, it's kind of comical some of the things that I get mad about or cry about. It's nothing really serious. It's a lot of it is just. Oh man, I'm just a piece of work right now, but blaming it all on the pregnancy hormones. So the last question is, what are you looking forward to most over the next couple weeks? And I am actually looking forward to going to visit family this weekend. Unfortunately, it is for a funeral. That's the sad thing about funerals is, I mean, it's a bittersweet thing. Funerals bring family together, and so I have a funeral this coming weekend, and it's kind of a sad situation. However, I am glad to be able to go and spend time with all of my cousins and family this weekend. We're all very close, and so I'm looking forward to just spending time with them, and I think it'll be really nice to get to do that this weekend. Okay, guys, last but not least, I'm gonna show you the bump. This is a maternity dress, like I said, so let's pull that. So here is our little girl. definitely a big bump. And I'm loving it, and I'm dealing with it at the same time, I guess you'd say. Like, it is just in charge and running the show here for this mama. Things are just gonna get so real over the next couple months, and then hopefully that last month will be all ready for her and just waiting until she decides to make her grand appearance. So anyway, if you guys aren't already, please subscribe and follow us along on this journey, and go ahead and follow me on Instagram for more day-to-day updates, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Bye! Thank you.